forever licked.
Your productivity is the reason I interest ambitious girls. See, I like the person that you are, but I'm in love with the person that you have potential to be. And all your dreams sharing with me, and your secrets bearing with me, and the flaws you don't even gotta mention to me. Ambitious girl, you just wanna win, and you rather chase your dreams than to try to chase these men that try to chase these skirts, that try to chase these shots with flavors that ain't even as sweet as her. My ambitious girl, I won't forget you. I just reflect on how I ain't met you yet, boo. You somewhere getting your life in order. So for this time being, I hope this open scribe might support her. The supporter, the worker.
First and foremost, I just wanted to come up here and thank everyone for the abundance of love we have received. I just appreciate every like, every share, every comment, all the love you have shown the girls thus far. We have gotten halfway through the season. So if you haven't already, make sure you catch up on episodes 1 through 6. The girls did an amazing job. I'm super proud of them. And we just hope that this project continues to help, inspire, encourage, or whatever it is you may be dealing with. The goal is to make sure that we are helping you. And they're also helping themselves by relieving these things, talking about these things that they have suppressed for years. So I'm super proud of you. We have about 5 to 6 more girls, including myself, that will share their project. That will share their stories on the BloomnSZN project before we get into season 2. So the concept of BloomnSZN came from a particular place I was in life. And I just remember sitting in my car and crying because I had finally realized, oh my God, I'm 26 years old. I have some goals that I achieved, but a lot of the major goals that I had, set for myself, I hadn't achieved them. And it just made me feel really less than, really low. And I was tired. I was drained. I have 3 children at this point, and I just feel like I'm not accomplishing enough. I'm not doing enough. And it just really made me feel, like crap. And I just remember crying so hard and praying, like, God, please show me what it is that I need to do, because this is not the life that I want. I want stability. I want consistency. I have all of these ideas and, dreams that I want to come true and I want to bring to life. But for the life of me, I couldn't get right. I would have a good job and I would be doing good, and I would just like get in this place where I'm like, this is boring, and I'm ready to shake something up, and I would move. I would quit. I would go back to situations that didn't feed, me and where I wanted to go, but it was comfortable in a sense. It wasn't comfortable, but it was what I knew. And so that caused me to backtrack a lot, and it caused me to kind of put a hold on everything that I wanted to do. And I just remember sitting in the car and I was crying and I was praying, and I'm like, Lord, I really need to hear from you. I know that I haven't, really been praying, and my focus has been off. And I knew this place was familiar, and every time I would get in this place, it was because I lost focus. I wasn't really focused on the matter of the hand. I was too concerned about my circumstances and my surroundings that I wasn't able to focus on my destination. And so he said to me, you're blooming. And I just remember like, how am I blooming? When you think of something blooming, you think of like a flower. You don't really necessarily think of the process. And at that present time, I was planted. And that's part of your blooming. You're not seeing results. You think it's bull crap. It's just kind of like, where am I? I feel stuck. But when you're planted, you are stuck. You're just this little seed. And you're planted in the dirt. It's cold. It's lonely. It's dark, and you don't really know. You don't really know until you start to nurture and take care of your garden. And to get out of that place, you know, I had to really do a lot of self-reflection. And I think that was the hardest part for me, because it forced me to realize a lot of things about myself that I had been ignoring, or, you know, I accepted, you know, just kind of like, that's just who I am. And it wasn't okay. And I think that that's the most frightening part of your journey, is realizing not only were some of the people you were dealing with toxic for you, you were toxic for yourself. And in order to bloom, you have to have a self-reflection moment, because you got to realize you play a part in a lot of your stagnation. You play a part of, you know, a major part of being still and not being still for the right reasons. You know, your fear, your comfortability, you know, conforming to what people think, your family members think that you should do this, or, you know, listening to everybody, you know, on social media, you know, you're doubting yourself and you are comparing yourself. And that's one major thing that you do not do. Comparison kills. It shot my self-esteem, because I felt like I went to school with this girl and she's buying houses and they got degrees, and here I am with my building and coding certificate, my pharmacy tech certificate, with three kids, and that's all I got to show for, you know. And I have been through so much, so many attempts at school, and just kind of like giving up and becoming discouraged, because I was going through so much and I wasn't really in it for the right reasons. And when I was in it for the right reasons, I wasn't focused like I needed to be. And so all of that is a part of your blooming season, even being planted. But once you start realizing, okay, these are the things that I need to change about me in order to get further into my blooming season, when I'm starting to reap my harvest and I'm starting to see the, you know, the outcome of these things that I'm changing within myself. And so in order for something to bloom, you have to what? You have to water it. You have to make sure it has the right amount of sunlight. You really have to put time into a garden. And if you're not being consistent and you're not feeding yourself positivity and you're not reading, you know, your word, or you're not praying, whatever helps you grow, if you're not doing these things, you don't go to the next level. And I'm not just talking about materialistic things. I'm talking about spiritually, emotionally, mentally, even physically. You know, if you don't put in work, just not, you get nothing. You get the same results, what you see right then and there. And so it really is major steps into blooming. It's not just, oh, boom, I overcame this and now I'm blooming. You know, even in your blooming season, you're not necessarily where you want to be. You have to focus on where you're trying to go and what are you trying to blossom into. The difference between being, you know, you're blooming and blossomed. And even when you, after you blossom, you know that you have to maintain that. You have to continue to do the same things you did, but go just a little bit harder. And, you know, once I realized, okay, I am blooming, but this is the level of blooming that I am in, it made me focus on me a lot more. What I'm trying to do, where I'm trying to go, the things that I'm trying to achieve. And it started to really dawn on me, like, well, I really am blooming, and that's what's up. And so are my friends, and I want this girl to bloom too, and I've seen her struggle with these things. And then it goes right back to me, like, nah, I'm not gonna do this, because then I have to be transparent, and then I have to be vulnerable, and then I have to let people into my life. And I'm a very private person, so I knew that in order for me to actually do what God told me to do, it would require more of me. And I wasn't ready to do that. Like, I'm not getting on nobody's national YouTube telling my story so people can be in my business. But you have to realize that it's not about you. Sometimes we go through things to help the next person. And I know it sounds weird. it, but it's really the truth. There is power in your testimony, and you don't even realize the help, you know, in your, that you give somebody just in your story, and it helps you too. And, you know, that's why I am so proud of these girls, because the relief they have, because they finally talked about something that they didn't talk about, has helped them. And that's all I want. I just want people to know that you're not alone. You are not alone. We all go through stuff. We are not perfect, besides what you see on Facebook and Twitter and Snapchat and Instagram. We're all normal people with obstacles that we have to overcome, with fears that we have to face. We've dealt with the unthinkable, and we're here and we're smiling, and that takes strength. Like, we are strong. And, you know, I know that even going through all of that, you don't feel strong, but you're very strong. And sometimes you don't even realize the power of, you know, the amount of strength you have until you have no choice but to use it. And so that's really where the BloomnSZN Project came from. The goal is just to help, you know, to encourage, to inspire, to motivate. I want everybody to take care of their garden, you know, nurture yourself so that you can bloom into what it is that you want to be. You know, don't be afraid. You know, don't feel like you can't go to the next level because of what your family tradition is. And, you know, follow your own dream. Follow your heart. Make sure you're praying to God to make sure that you're in His will. And really just focus on you so that you can change the things that you need to change in order for you to get to the next level. So the first one is, I want you to focus on your destination. Don't focus on circumstances, what it looks like around you, or pit stops that you might be at. Really focus on your destination. Don't give up, because if you don't keep going, you're not gonna, you know, make it to where you're trying to go. So just never stop. Be consistent, you know, even if it's slow. Any progress is better than none at all. Two, I really want to encourage you to be consistent in everything you do. If you're not consistent, you definitely won't see results. Sometimes even when you are consistent, you may not see results right then and there, but just keep going. It ties into number one. Don't focus on circumstances. Don't focus on pit stops. Just be consistent. Continue to go. And three, don't get discouraged. Do not be discouraged. Don't become weary in well doing. I promise you, it's going to pay off. It's going to be worth it. And it's liberating. It's really liberating to actually growing and loving yourself and getting to know yourself, accepting things about yourself that you are unable to change, and changing the things that you can, you know. But if you become discouraged, you know, it kind of puts you in just like this reckless place. At least I can say for me, you know, when I become discouraged, it's not like, oh, well, it's me. I just start doing reckless stuff, you know, off the meat rack, wilding. So don't be discouraged. Where you are is not your final destination. Like I said, you got to keep it trucking. You got to keep it moving and believing and having faith. Going through your blooming season takes a lot of faith. And I encourage everybody to have a prayer life. One of my great friends on Facebook, Ashley, she's of She Flourishes Ministry. She is doing a prayer movement called She Pray 30, is where, you know, praying for 30 days and, you know, growing your relationship with God, strengthening your prayer life. So make sure you follow and you like her, She Flourishes Ministries Faith and Restoration page on Facebook, so you can keep up with her and find out when the next one starts. But that's all that I have. There will not be an episode this week, but I just wanted to kind of like do a message for me kind of thing. To just explain what the BloomnSZN Project was about, and just encourage everybody to be grateful in your blooming season. Be in tune. Make sure you're really focusing on the right things and not just kind of looking for the outcome of everything. But really learning and embracing and growing in your blooming season. The next episode is going to be next Sunday. There are about 6 more episodes. We're almost finished, and there will be a blooming season 2. So if you are interested in coming on this platform and sharing your story and also trying to heal yourself, you can contact me, and I would love to share more with you how the process goes. All right, so I don't just say because it sounds good. I say because I mean it. I love you as nobody else tells you, and you are great, and you're going to be great, and you're going to do magnificent things, but you can't do it if you don't keep going. Everybody be blessed and have a wonderful week. Elba.
It's gonna work out sooner than later. You don't have to worry about tomorrow. It's gonna work out in your favor. Just keep your head to the sky. Keep your eyes on the prize. Just keep your head to the sky. Keep your eyes on the prize.